Okay, we're looking at trait bound syntax. What is trait bound syntax? You can see it's a function, and we have a trait type being used as a parameter, a function parameter to the trait is a parameter to the function, shall we say. The trait bound syntax ensures that only types implementing the talk trait can be used with the talks function. So that's the function. Up here I've created a trait. So if we go to the top of the code, I've got a struct called cat, struct called cow, and a struct called human. And obviously they all make different noises, but they all make some sort of noise. So I've done an implementation of my trait talk for the cat. So meow. I've done one for the cow that says moo, and I've done one for the human that says hello. So I've got three structs, three imples, and one trait. So depending on what's passed in to the function will affect what it does, whether it says moo, hello, or meow. So let's just go back to ChatGPT and just kind of I'll read what it did, what it produced when I asked it to summarize my code. In summary, this code defines a trait called talk with a talk method. So talk lowercase for the function name, talk uppercase for the trait. Implements that trait for a type human. So in a minute, I'll modify it to also demonstrate it with a cat, for instance, which prints out the message, including the name field, and finally provides a function talks that takes any object implementing the talk trait. So we've got three objects. We've got the cat, the cow, and the human. And it calls the talk method. So depending on whether we pass in a cow, a cat, or a human will affect what we get out. But all three implement the trait bound syntax. So if I run this, obviously we're just going to get the human talk. Hello, says Bob. So I didn't want to put you through the agony of watching me type all of this code from scratch. So let's go for kit equals cat's name. Tiddles to string. And there we go. And then what we need to do next is do talks and pass in the name of the variable, which is kit. So kit is the name of the variable. The actual name of the cat is Tiddles, and we'll see what happens next when we run the code. I didn't close that properly, did I? Sorry. Right, let's run it now. Cargo run. And hello says Bob, and meow says Tiddles. So you can see, depending on what you pass in, you get a different function being called. So that is my interpretation of a trait bound syntax, but if you want, check it out on ChatGPT or also check out page 119 of the Rust Crash course. So that's kind of a quick whistle stop tour of trait bound syntax. Don't take my word for it, try it out. So thanks for watching, and even if this has not been very cohesive, at least I will provide you with the Rust Playground link in the video description so you can try it out and you don't have to type it all in from scratch. So thanks for watching, and I'll be back soon.